Thank you. move out of your way, too.
Thank you, dude. Y'all go ahead.
Welcome to Santa Ana Bowl, where tonight it's a season opener, folks, on Channel 31 SAUSD TV, Channel 31, here in the county seat of Santa Ana, the county seat city here in Orange County. My name is Peter Pigskin Hebner, along with the one, the only, the Professor Knox Wozzie. Knox, we got football season, and we've got an intra-city rivalry. The Santa Ana Saints in red versus the Godinez Grizzlies in Pittsburgh Steelers colors.
Great to be here again. Another great year of football. Ishmael Mojica kicking up for Santa Ana. They won the toss, elected to kick. Fine kick down about the 2-yard line.
Here you go. Return man on the right side there is going from the south goal to the north. Dipsy doodles his way down the side and then finally gets shoved out of bounds. Doesn't even get hit and knocked down. Maintains his balance very nicely. A good return there out to about the 37-yard line. Return man for Godinez is number 28, Andy Sosa, who's regularly a running back, a junior, 5'9", 186 pounds. The Godinez football roster has got about 67 kids. Santa Ana, a lot fewer, maybe about 20, 21 fewer. They draw from a smaller roster as far as number of kids. 4-4 defense for the Santa Ana Saints, and decked out in their full red pants and shirts. First and 10. They'll switch quarterbacks around a little bit. Godinez well, kicks out, takes a snap. Cross runner takes this run, and he's looking for some room on that left side. Spins around, down he goes, and he turns the corner, gets out to about the plus 30, his own 38-yard line. Nice run there. Good sidewise running.
Santa Ana started out in a 4-4 defense, one safety. And the defensive end stood up a bit that time on the first power sweep. The family play around the left end, or as it's called, student body left. Good power play, got the edge. Second and 2 yards to go.
8 yard gain, Grizzly ball. Second and 8, yes, at their own 39. Shotgun, they'll mostly run shotgun most of the night. And once in a while, he'll line up behind the center. Dispy Doodle outruns one and kind of outmoves a second before he finally trips up and loses his balance. Number 23 on the run there, Patrick McMorris, plays quarterback, running back, and wide receiver. He's only a sophomore. He does it all.
Interesting, they ran a naked bootleg on the second play of the game. Interesting misdirection right away. They're not going to try to set him up too much and then run it. I always like that. Run the counter play before you run the regular. That's good. He gained about, it was a first down, first and 10, game just underway.
5 yards gain, first and 10 at their own 44. Shotgun snap, gives it to number 13, looking for some room, runs into the backfield and comes up. Sardis steps his way down, enough for the first down. He picks up the first down on first down, finally getting knocked down by Santa Ana's Leo Lucio.
But as you can see, holding behind the play. Good job by Santa Ana standing the play up that time. They extended it to the ball, carried him to the outside, but a fine cut on the running back. Cut it up inside. Again, good defense, but a good cut up, good gain, but a holding call brought it back.
You know, Knox, I got to tell you, the Godinez Grizzlies, they like yellow because that's one of the major colors, but they don't like that kind of yellow. So it pushes them back 10 yards. It'll be first down. They'll retain the down. But yeah, first and 20, so kind of nullifies the exciting offensive start that they got. So they'll regroup here. We'll get you the offensive lineman from left to right here. Just give us one moment. And off to the right side they go. Wide gap there, look out. Doing some damage as he high steps it all the way down to about the 43, 44 yard line, not bad. And that once again is number 23 there. 23 is Patrick McMorris.
Good series of counter plays using the quarterback. Looks like a fine athlete. They're gonna get him the ball as much as they can. Again, penalty on the play. Walking, I believe this is south at this field. We're at the Santa Ana Bowl, of course. wait for the flag. The referee is Brian Brennan, associated by Tom Innocente, Rich Van Vliet, Garrett McDonald, and Paul Hubbard. It is... Okay, that must have been against Santa Ana. So it's moved its first in about 20 now instead of about 30.
I could have, well, I saw that, the holding motion by the one of the officials, but I could have... I guess so.
It's not like pro ball, the automatic first down.
Actually, now they got three linebackers instead of four. The cornerback kind of looks big enough to be a high school linebacker. Nice high snap, but it's right to the quarterback. Looking for that room on that left side, and they don't find it. Down he goes. Hit him hard, hit him low. Wasn't about to let him go. Nice bring down there by Santa Ana's number 23, Tui Leibau. Leibau, a lot of vowels.
Now that's the way to play the edge. He missed it on the first one, got hooked. That time he strung it out, strung him backwards. I wouldn't be surprised. They went into a more normal sure pass defense. That was like a 4-3 that time out of the 4-4. One of these days you're going to see a pass out of that, a halfback pass, to try to loosen up. They tried that again, but a fine defensive play by the defensive end. Pushing back. It is now second about a mile and a half.
It's a lot. Look out. We got second down and 31 yards to go at their own 23. So they're marching backwards, folks. Stay in a shotgun. You have yet to throw the ball. And it fools nobody as that left side of the defensive line just smothers them to death. About four or five guys in red shirts there, turfing him in really good. He had nowhere to go. A little bit breakdown of offensive protection there on the right side of the offensive line for the Rodriguez Grizzlies. Their lineman left to right is Solano, Jesus Solano, Mario Aprecio, Josh Trujillo is a center snapping the football, Mario Lopez, both the guards are sophomores, both Marios are sophomores, and the right tackle is Jason Flores Jr. Your offensive line for the Godinez Grizzlies in white, black, and yellow.
This is where you turn around and you say, Coach, got any 3rd and 31 plays? Okay, 4-3 defense, sure pass over his head.
Look out.
He's in trouble, he's down. It'll now be 4th and about 40. Good defensive stand with a big penalty early. First play of the game, they got around the corner, then the counterplay for good yardage. Good adjustments already by Santa Ana. I like the way they've adjusted, make some plays, make them do something different the next time. They've played much better defense the last few plays.
Max, I got to tell you, you know what, that drive kind of reminded me of a date with a really hot girl. You thought you were going to get somewhere with her at the beginning of the date, and by the end of the night, you just got a kiss on the cheek at night, and that was it. That drive started off real juicy and ended up real dry.
Or a punt.
You got that right. They're punting from their own end zone. Look, a low snap. Oh, look how he handles it, though, on a bounce. Look out. Good punt, not high, but very decent, very nice, and it definitely takes a Godinez bounce. Very good kick indeed. Bounces out of bounds at around the minus 47 for the Saints, so they'll still have pretty good field position, but give some credit to the punter there. He did a good job under pressure. He did a great job under pressure.
That was a very athletic play. The center snap, as you know, most of you know, is one of the tougher plays. Anything below pro football, even there, it can be a circus. But in high school, it's, oh, what do we got? A low snap, great recovery, decent kick under pressure, and tremendous field position at the 49 and half yard line for Santa Ana. The Saints' first drive of the year.
Saints have got about three guys that go both ways. Godinez has enough kids where they have no guys that go both ways. That counts in the fourth quarter when guys can tire out if there's a lot of them on the field all the time. Godinez has none. Oh, fumble on first down. And they pick it up. Look out. Godinez has got it. They're going to return. He stays on the outside lane and just kind of walks out of bounds there. And that is a legitimate fumble, and he picked it up. Wow, how about that? A one-play drive, and it's dead. So the Santa Ana Saints, oh, man, mistakes here right at the beginning. Some kind of, I think one player went down on the sidelines there.
He was hit late. They looked at it, did not call a penalty. That's a judgment call of the referees. Not arguing that, but I think he got hit over there.
Did he get hit by one of his own guys?
No, well, I think he ran up against cheerleaders or concrete walls or into the ground. But he was hit late, not a heavy hit, and they did not call a penalty. And one of the officials was right on top of it.
I think it's Gerson Lopez, number 10. He's
yeah.
Safety.
Yeah, and he's the one who picked that up. That was pistol formation. Tried to, with the run up the middle, got for a couple of yards and then the fumble. And as you could see, he was hit a little bit out of bounds. Did not call a penalty, not enough to get a penalty, but enough to put him down, and he's not feeling very good right now.
He's not exactly motionless, but he's not moving around that much either, so this does not look good. And we are here tonight. We got off to a kind of a semi-late start. My name is Peter Pigskin Hebdo, and along with you for another game and another season here of exciting varsity football here in the great town of Santa Ana. Peter Pigskin Hebdo, along with the one, the only, the Professor Knox Wazzy, our stellar color announcer. And he is up and walking under his own power with a little bit of help.
Yeah.
He's okay, but I'm sure they'll pull him off for a few plays to get his bearings and catch his breath. He'll be all right.
I talked to the officials before the game about any new rules. They said, not much. We're going to worry about a few things. But I asked about protocols on concussions. He said they're following the National Federation of High School Football as well as the National Trainers Association. Everybody's working on these together. There's a bunch of things. So if there's any chance of anything like that, they're all over it. Everybody's watching for it. Extra precaution, especially the first game of the year. I don't know if that was a head injury or not, but whatever it was, they're all aware of it.
You know, if you look at the Santa Ana Saints, their colors are the exact color scheme of the old Houston Oilers. It's just dominant with red instead of blue, instead of the very sky blue. Look out. Hands off. Looks like he wanted to toss it here, but he takes off on the run. Yeah, it looked like it was an option there. Ooh, he got blasted too hard inside the 40.
18, I believe, came up from safety.
He got knocked.
Good job playing downhill from the safety position.
Yeah, he ran it inside to about the 38-yard line. Yeah, number 18, Ricardo Garcia, cornerback, senior, 5'11", 146 pounds. He might not be really big, but he put a hell of a hit on him on that one. Wow.
But also, I like the way the defensive line and everybody strung it out. Made him run sideways, and sideways is fun, but it doesn't get any yards down the field. Set him up, and the man came up and made a good play. He's the left cornerback over there. It'll be second and nine. We have 7:25 left in the first quarter. No score. First game of the year. Gonitas and Santa Ana from the Santa Ana Bowl. Timeout by the official. Wants to talk to the head coach. And the referee is Brian Brennan.
And the Godinez team, these guys, young school, only been around about 10 years. And Coach K was a coach, head coach for many years. Two seasons ago, the 14 season, I think they went winless or they won one game, but he was such a huge, huge rash of injuries, and I believe he still teaches there. We still have a timeout.
They did call a timeout. Coach's decision, CD as they say, and that was an official timeout. He just didn't like what he saw, and he's not going to lose track of it now, so he walked out and called timeout again. Who is the head coach for Godinez?
Godinez, Michael Esteves. Nice man. He teaches on campus, and he keeps busy. He's an English teacher.
How long has he been there?
He's been there for, this is the beginning of his third year, but his second year as a head coach.
And I believe that's the same as the Santa Ana coach.
Yeah, Santa Ana's third year, and that is Charlie Tevant-Gort. He's a graduate of the school I'm a big fan of, and you're somewhat of a fan of, the University of Utah Utes in red.
Yeah, he has a connection there. I have a connection. I knew the coach's son back in the early 50s when I was a whole lot younger, and actually ended up being mascot for the team along with his son Jim Curtis. That was the great Cactus Jack Curtis. And then Pete lived in Salt Lake.
I have a slight connection. I went to high school right down the street. My older sister went to school there, so I have a little bit of a connection to U of U.
Yeah, actually probably as much or more. And then he went there, so we had a good laugh about Utah earlier.
I am a fan, a big fan. They're my team.
The big red of Santa Ana is the big red of Utah.
Same exact red. You got that right. Look, the big bruiser back right down the middle like a knife through soft butter. Look out! Still thundering his way, lumbers his way. Gets all the way down about the 22-yard line before he's hit and knocked down. But wow, nice carry. You're not going to stop him on a first hit with one man. You're not.
Also, very well-designed play. That was sort of a scissors or counter play. Second man. You used to call that almost a cross buck back in the old days. But that was another variation off that whole pattern. They've got the whole playbook in already. And that was a well-timed play up the middle, wide open. It probably trapped them, prepped the gap in the middle.
Nicky Tauchiwi, and he is a mainstay as a middle linebacker, too. There he lines up as a fullback. Here he is again, looks for some room on the right side, shifts in, look out, squares his shoulders down, he goes around the 10-yard line before he's upended, kind of goes rolling, but good clean hit there. Involved in that stop for Santa Ana's number three, Matthew Durantes, a linebacker, senior, returning starter, 6'2", 200, one of the bigger kids, one of the taller kids, there on the Saints' side.
He's listed at 5'10", 245, and he runs heavy.
Yeah, he does. He's a, look out, that is the true, true build of a fullback. He defines it. So clock is ticking, scoreless first quarter, 6:48 going here to go in the first. And, of course, the deepest we've seen any drive here, of course, so far in this game. It's still obviously very early here at the bowl. You're watching Varsity Football on SAUSD Channel 31 here. Station. All right, first down. Look out. Deep man takes it. He gets upended. Down he goes. No one picked him up. Very nice, hard, clean hit. He had him in the grasp immediately almost by 45. Yeah, 45 there for the Saints. 45 is Kevin Sia, S-C-E-A. I've never seen that last name before. That's a unique one. Defensive lineman, senior, 5'7", 245. He kind of looks like a fullback as well. So the Saints being challenged here. Got to stiffen up. They are the only injuries they have, unfortunately, to their two most exciting players. The brothers Briseño are both out, unfortunately, with injuries. John and George are seniors this year.
Daylight.
Look out. Plenty of room on that left side. He's probably going to cut in. He does. Into the end zone he goes. Touchdown. Practically untouched. How about that? Number 28, Andy Sosa, running back junior, crashes through for the first points of the night at 6-0.
Fine blocking on the outside that time. They'd run up the middle a couple of times on the counters inside and popped the big back. That time they ran the sweep, and there was nothing but fame and glory ahead of him. That was a good job.
Yeah, that was a nice play.
Good series, good blocking.
Very well executed. Knox, that one came out pretty much just as what, just as how it was written up on the chalkboard, right?
They were playing against air in practice.
There you go. So they're gonna. Some high schools will do this where they'll spread out their guy.
They just want to see if you adjust.
Yeah. And then
they may shift back to a regular one. If you don't, if you don't adjust, they'll run it on you.
So this is. You see, this is a lot more.
Okay, here we go. Now we'll shift into kicking.
This is rare to see years ago, and it's more common, a lot more common now.
Common. It takes away practice time. That's what you do it. Because you make them play that instead of do other things.
Oh, babble snap. Look out. The holder's going to have to run with it. He's going to go for it on the left side there. Can he get in? I don't think so. No, he got thundered. He thunders his way. A lot of sideways running, and it didn't quite turn the corner. Down he goes. So the emergency two-point conversion does not convert. Didn't get in. Tried to. Valiant effort there by Isaac Verduzco. Verduzco, wide receiver and running back. He's a junior. Not that big, 5'8", 160, but a gutsy guy, but he did all he could. He had limited, wasn't limited with space, but he was limited as far as blocking protection in that emergency situation. Down he goes, and the Grizzlies will have to suffice for a 6-0 lead here as we are halfway through the first quarter. You might hear some birds chirping right now. The common green parrots here of Santa Ana. I live on the very south west edge of town, where the image-conscious people call it South Coast Metro. Folks, let's be honest, it's Santa Ana. I'm plenty proud to say it's Santa Ana. And I hear those birds outside the trees in my apartment at times. You never know where they're going to be, but they're always in Santa Ana. They just flew over the field, if you could hear them. The last five of them going right now. So we have our football and we have our wildlife. All right. So, of course, the kickoff in the 40 at the old high school, at the high school level. And eons ago, when I was a kid, and Knox, when you were... Of course, you were a kid.
A half ago.
There you go. They used to kick off from the 40 in the good old National Football League, but of course, those rules have changed. But it was that way.
They won't kick off at all.
You're probably right from the way things are going, from what I've been reading. You're right. As an injury prevention measure. But of course, you could argue that the kickoff return and punt returns are some of the more exciting plays, or can be at least. A higher percentage of them, one of the more exciting plays in the sport of football. Of course, in the high school level, you kick it in the end zone. Here in California, at least, it's automatically a touchback. You do not have the choice of running it out as an injury prevention measure. High kick, good
another
kick.
Another good high school kickoff.
About 5 yard line. Return man looking for some room on the right side. He cuts towards the middle and he gets thrashed by one guy. Good hit there. Decent return there, but by number 13, Chris Nava. And he gets his guys out to about the 20 yard line. He did some speedy running, but he got caught up to, and down he goes. So the Santa Ana Saints, they will come out first and 10. And from left to right, for them, you've got Eddie Lattes, left tackle. Left guard is Mark Hernandez. Jesus Vieira, V-I-E-R-R-A, is a center snapping that football tonight. Jose Zaragoza is your right guard, and the right tackle is Francisco Franco. And they will sometimes line up with a tight end, sometimes not. Most of the time they do not. Shotgun they come. Good snap right there. Looks to kind of like a run to that right tackle side and just kind of smothered, maybe a yard. Probably
no
will give
flag,
him
though. He said he got set again.
A couple guys involved in that stop. More than one big perpetrator in the play that was laying the lumber. For Godinez, I believe, led the charge. Number 54, Giovanni Lucas. Defensive end, senior, 5'9", 185. Kind of light for a DE. But you see him in all shapes and sizes here in the high school varsity level here in the Southland. So, no gain. Second and 10, Saints. Your quarterback, of course, is number 2, Damian Macias. A lot of vowels in these names tonight. Stretching to that long side, shakes one tackler, still on his feet, good balance, nice job, not near the first down, but just short of it. Not bad, had the long side of the field, and he used every inch that he could. Not bad, number 17, Pablo Aguirre. Wide receiver and, of course, athlete. He plays a lot of different positions. We've seen that in other rosters, Knox, elsewhere. He's a utility guy.
Best one I saw like that was the kid at Pasadena. I hope, remember the Pasadena quarterback? Or that? I couldn't know it. Something like that. But I hope we get to do the Pasadena Muir Turkey Tussle in the Rose Bowl again. We've done that several years in a row now. That's one of the highlights. That's fun.
The cable come
down here too, though, but that's fun.
That one's fun for the tradition of being at the bowl, and Santa Ana's fun because it's convenient for me to get to the games. I live here right in town. Of course, Knox, you come all the way from Upland. We appreciate that. We'll be out tonight doing Saddleback's game against Seagerstrom. Snaps it, rolls out to the right. Nice short pass. It's caught. Make sure he's got it. And he does more damage. Yak, yak, yak. My favorite stat, yardage after catch. Give it a nice gold star there on his helmet to Tui Liavao. Liavao made sure he squared his shoulders, made sure he got it, secured it first, and then he took off, had plenty of room to work with. That's good coaching. He's a good kid, knows what he's doing out there.
Several things I like about that. I like the way the quarterback got it under control, good blocking to get him out there free.
Nice play.
And he followed through, turned his shoulders, good catch, and a good downfield block by the other wide receiver. He turned and got his man out of the way. That's good, too. Got to get that one extra 8 or 10 yards to get that one extra block.
Not every play, but we some good plays here tonight with good execution. That was one of them, really good execution. Three receivers to that long side, the left side, the quarterback. As he takes off to that left side on an option play, keeps it, look out, looking for blocking help, gets it, still on his feet. Blizzes the way down inside the 40, still going, even with guys on his back. All the way down to the plus 35-yard line. Oh, man, all these penalty flags are coming. Nullifying some really nice plays tonight. Oh, they're going to bring this one back. This stinks. If you're a Saints fan, he ain't happy right now.
Okay, they tightened up the rules on clipping, they were telling me before the games, inside the box. I wonder if that's what that is. Holding. No, holding's the call. But they have tightened up. You can't blindside, crackback sort of thing. They're tightening up on that. That's not actually a new rule, but they're enforcing it more. And that was interesting. That was an option play where he says, I'm not going to pitch. I'm the option. And so the man just kept trailing him and keeps stringing the defensive out. But he kept going for good yardage, but a hold behind the play.
I don't know if we're a curse when we come to these games or not, Knox, but we tend to see a lot of long gains and nice plays that attract penalty flags, especially on offense. So
that's one way you can get that extra 10 yards, get past the line of scrimmage as a hold.
It's first down and 21 yards to go from their own 36. So instead of the plus 35 at your own 36, that's a huge difference of almost 30 yards. That's not small change. And we have, ladies and gentlemen, flags are thrown and whistles are blown. We have a dead ball foul on the field. Had to get that out of the way, Knox. No.
I know. Okay, I'll mark that off the bucket list for the year.
That's it. Only once a game. I don't want to overdo it. So, somebody move before the ball will snap.
It'll be a free 5 yards, though.
Can't do that in football, especially when you are, they jumped off sides. Pardon me. Of course, if you're a lineman on the offense, you're supposed to stay still. If you're a defensive guy, you can't jump in the neutral zone. They did, and they snapped the football. So, 5 yards, and the Saints will have it first down. Still, first down. They have to get to the opposition's 42-yard line, and they're at their own 41. So we'll call about 19 yards, almost 20. Going deep here. Nope, going mid-range. Caught. Nice leaping grab. Needs to catch right in between the seams. Nice job there by Chris Nava once again. This kid does a really good job of getting his body behind it. Uses his whole body to make that catch, not just his hand.
Good play. Didn't gain a lot. Gained about 8 or 9 yards. A solid play. And they needed about 20, so they get like that. Don't get too gritty. They had a man going deep, and he just filled the inside. That was a good play.
Yeah, not bad. They look sharp. So on that one, it's going to be second down. And we'll call it 12 yards to go or so. Again, the Saints at their own 47-yard line or so, 46, 47 or so. Shotgun they come, of course. And first man takes it. Hesitation, bounces off one white shirt, and then down he goes. It not until the second wave bring him down, almost near the first down, or very close to the first down. Nice run there by number 20, Alan Pacheco. Pacheco, nice dash there for about 8-9 yards. How about that?
And fifth, short, third and very short.
And Giovanni Lucas, Lucas made the stop. He was a linebacker there for the Grizzlies in white, black, and yellow. Third down and 1 yard to go. Money play here, folks. Two receivers to the left, one to the right. The long side's the left. He goes to the left. Slot man takes the catch. Flag is down before the play is developed. And he's got the first down. But hold the phone, folks. We got litter on the field.
It's a good safe play, but I have the feeling of
illegal procedure. False start. Illegal procedure. All kind of, sort of the same thing. But whatever you want to call it, they're going to march it off against the Saints. Five more yards. So, again, two steps forward and three steps back.
Legal procedure, that's an 8-yard penalty.
Well, they
it was third and eight. Now it's third and eight.
That's strange. That's a 5-yard penalty, right?
I do not understand. Legal procedure is a 5-yard penalty. That didn't change. Other things changed, that didn't change. I have no idea what that's about. Maybe it's spot of the foul, but that's not legal procedure.
It might be the new math. I don't know.
New math, I know, you're right.
Third and eight. A little bit of creeping up by the linebackers here on the right side for the Godinez Grizzlies. And now we got flags. Did they step into the neutral zone or did the Saints move? Illegal procedure against the Saints once again. So they kind of goaded him into it. But if you're a lineman, you got to keep your cool and stay still. Don't move before the snap count. That's all you got to know to do. And they don't do it. So
that was a 5-yard penalty. That one I can understand.
So somebody moved, I think it was on the left side of the line when those linebackers on the right side of the defensive line were kind of moving and kind of trying to goad them, and they were successful. Third down and 13 for the Saints. Quick snap, rolls to his left, puts it up. Hands go up and the ball goes down. We got a batted pass. Nice job by, I think, number seven? Yeah, seven, lucky number seven. Got his mitts up, and his meat hooks brought the ball down. Carlos Elizalde, outside linebacker, senior, I believe he's a returning starter, 5'8", 165 pounds. Nice job by him, nullifies the Santa Ana drive.
There's a saying in baseball, those bases on balls, the walks that kill you. Here, those illegal procedures, the non-forced errors. Tough to get to them like that. For 13 total yards and penalties, I'm not sure about that, but anyway. The miss on the drive, punt situation. Bad snap. Here we go.
I'll let you do this. He's got to scramble this. He's got some time to work with, though. He still had time to maybe punt it away, and he just...
Yeah, he wasn't making it any worse than it was. I can understand that.
Number 12, that really wasn't his fault. It was just a high snap there. He did all he could. Number 12, we don't have a 12 on the roster. I've got the bad eyes here. Forgive me. Number 18 is the punter. 18 is Ricardo Garcia.
If any of you want to make a donation for somewhere, I think there's probably a IRS categorization if you want to donate for long snap school. Getting kids to go to it, it's tough to do. I'm not making fun of them at all. I know how tough it is. It is hard to do. You've got to practice and under pressure and stuff, but you got to work at it. That's two of them, one on both sides now.
Yeah, years ago there was no LS long snapper on the rosters. Now there are everywhere. Look out. Bounces off one set of players, and down he finally goes, loses his balance. A great effort there, but not much yardage. Maybe a yard or two. Maybe two and a half. And that was hard to see the number as he has yet to turn around in my favor here. Tailback kid ran it. And to the left side there, a couple yards. As the one thing I like about Godin is it's a wide mixture of players in that offensive backfield. It's not one just go-to guy that they go to. So they mix it up nicely. That was 28 for Godinez. That was Andy Sosa, the running back. He's a junior. Second and six to go from the eight. They can get the first down at the 2-yard line. Look out, they keep it down the middle. The Saints plug it up, maybe a yard. And they were just kind of lucky to hang on that football. Look out, it was number 33, the fullback, the big dude for them. Richie, let's make sure I'm saying his name correctly here. Tauchiwi. Again, Solano. Jesus Solano is your left tackle. He's a junior. In the 15 season. Mario Aprecio, sophomore left guard. Josh Trujillo, senior, returning starter, snapped in football tonight. Right guard, the other sophomore, the other Mario Lopez. And the right tackle is Jason Flores, Jr., for your Godinez Grizzlies in white. We're inside. 30 seconds of ticking here in the first quarter. They're leading 6-0, the Grizzlies are, and they're trying to take a bigger commanding lead here, but we have a whistle, but no flags. We got a timeout. Timeout on the part of the Godinez Grizzlies. All right, Knox, trivia time. We have a little time here. NFL trivia, of course. What man, as far as I know, I could be wrong, but I believe he's the only guy in modern football history to have lost a starting quarterback position. He was starters at three different franchises. He played for more than three franchises, but he lost his starting position at three different franchises, obviously, to three men who later, after their playing days, became Hall of Fame quarterbacks. This is within the last, say, 40 years, so it's somebody you should be able to get.
No idea. It's a great question. I would say Earl Morrow, but I don't know who you mean.
I'll give you a hint. He wore number 17 pretty much everywhere he went. 17, which is not that common for a quarterback.
Not far,
no. It was Steve DeBerg.
Denver, I think, too.
He was in San Francisco, lost it to Montana in the late 70s, lost his slot to Elway, of course, and Elway got there in 83. And then he lost it to
Elway.
Elway was second, and then third was Steve Young, Tampa Bay, when Steve Young was with the Buccaneers back in 84-85. 36 from the 8. Godinez looking for some room on the left side, and that gap is closed. Down he goes! He pulled him down really from his back. A nice stop by number 31.
They tried to fiddle him and go into the short side of the field.
Roger Leone
made a good play. Good defense that time. Going to the short side didn't work. That is the end of the first quarter. We have a 6-0 Godinez lead over Santa Ana.
He just grabbed the sides and says, "You going down?" And down he went. It was a solo tackle. Nice, good, clean hit. Yep, they'll switch the sides here. And the Saints, if they can maybe keep into a field goal attempt, to be a little bit of a moral victory, because it's fourth down. We'll be fourth down when they replay on the south end here at the Santa Ana Bowl. And we usually only get out here once, maybe twice at the most a year, and it's usually not till later in the season. But our first game here this season that we're taping and we're broadcasting here at the Bowl. This place has been around for, I think, like 70 years. Seen a lot of history. Of course, the fake field that they have now, or the fake grass, I should say. It's made from the that composite plastic. It's very player-friendly. It's got a lot of bounce to it. It's nothing like AstroTurf at all. So many fields have got this type of field now with the rubber pellet base made from shredded tires. So it recycles tires. That's good, obviously. But the thing is, it's so low maintenance. It needs no watering. You know, it needs cleaning and all that type of thing from here and there from time to time. But Orange Coast College has now got a field like this. They've had it for 10 years. I remember doing a game here years ago with another cable company, Orange Coast versus Santa Ana Junior College, and it was just it was a mud bath. It was, and the final score, I think, was 6-2. There was just nobody could get any footing. And I remember they slid in the mud to celebrate their victory after the game was over. I think Orange Coast to win the game. It was crazy. Kicker in for 28. It was Andy Sosa, I believe. 13's the holder. Yeah, and the holder, your holder is Isaac Verduzco.
I believe number 7 is the long snapper. You find anybody you can for long snap. It doesn't matter if they're a defensive back or attack. I think 7's in the middle there. I'm not sure, he may be blocking, but you got to get somebody with the guts and the idea to get in there.
We'll get a name break up the play here. So yeah, field goal attempt here from the 22, so 32 yarder. It's got some distance. Look out! I think it's inaccurate though. Yeah, it was wide to the right, a little bit short.
The snapper was Carlos Elizalde, outside linebacker, senior, 5'8", 165. You don't have to be big. You just have the guts to get in there. I admire him for doing that.
So there's a little bit of wind here tonight. It's definitely a windy night. I mean, not terribly, but enough. It's noticeable. So that might have been a bigger factor. Of course, that end is kind of wide open. So a bit of a moral victory there for the Saints. And, of course, that's kind of big because it keeps it still a one-score game. And you score a touchdown, and, of course, you kick the extra point. You can take the lead. If you're down 9-0, you score a touchdown and go for two, you're still down by one. So that... you never know. It could be a big difference maker. Saints take over at the 20-yard line. So, yeah, anytime you're kicking it from inside the 20, or the line of scrimmage goes inside the 20, the opposing team gets it back if the kick is missed at the 20. And that's a good rule. There's a different quarterback in there this time for the Saints. Number 14 in shotgun is Julian Gomez.
That is called against four if you prefer. Said, yeah, the coach, I'm not sure they're the right players on there, but I think they rang him up with the timeout.
I would say roughly the Saints roster is two guys, probably three guys that Gardenas has. So they drop from a bigger population for the team. Santa Ana is about 3,000 students. Gardenas is less. I think it's like 2,300 or so. But Gardenas is, they have more kids that go off of football. Think about a lot of the kids in Santa Ana, you know, a lot of them of Latino descent. A lot of them at these high schools have not played any organized football until they reach high school. I was talking with the Valley head coach, Larry Moore, and he was saying that, you know, we get a lot of talent out of these guys, and we get a lot of, he says, I'm surprised they're as skilled as they are when they come in, because, you know, a lot of these schools, the public schools here in Santa Ana, they're playing football for the first time once they're a freshman. So, you know, there's not much experience going in. A lot of these guys play youth soccer or other sports, and you know, football is new to them once they hit high school, but they want to try it. First down and 10 yards to go. And they get reset here. They're at the end of play. Two receivers to the left, one to the right. The long side is the right. The wide is a little high snap, and he handles it, pitches it. Tailback takes it, looking for some room on that left side. It gets slammed in hard. Good hard clean it, caught him from behind. Not bad. It was number 17 on the left.
It's number 14, sophomore Julian Gomez in a quarterback right now.
Getting up on the high steps his way down to about the 22. Not bad. I thought he had a few more yards than that, but yeah, just a few-yard gain, but he's got that high kick style of running there. And again, the Bresenio brothers are out with injuries. We'll give you the details here in a minute. The senior dynamic duo, who are some of the most exciting runners I've seen on the football field ever since I've done high school football. And I've announced games for nearly 30 seasons. Look out. Down the middle they go. Hit him hard, hit him low. Wasn't about to let him go. Hit him around the ankles. Nice run. He did what he could with it, though. Pablo Aguete once again. And he had him right around. And nice job by him. Yeah, Perea, number 24, outside linebacker. Perea. So Saints trying to get something offensively started here. They've got some exciting plays. Some decent plays in the first drive, but they nullified themselves. The previous drive that they had was really a bigger problem with penalties than they had a problem with Godinez's defense. So they got to just not beat themselves. They should be having a decent game here tonight. They're doing all they can with, again, the Bresenio brothers out. Those are their stars. Shotgun, looking, has some protection, puts it up, short pass, it's caught around the line of scrimmage, still on his feet. First tackle moves him. Oh, the second one bounced him, goes down, he coughs up the football, but alertly right next to it, how about that, was Ricardo Garcia. He recovers. What a goofy play.
Good screen pass. Interesting, he fumbled forward, and the man recovered, and they get in the advance. I'm not sure that's the football rule. I think that might be, what's the one in San Diego? The Holy Roller. Holy Roller. Yeah.
That was one of the craziest plays I've ever seen.
Yeah, there was the one in Pittsburgh, of course, but the Holy Roller.
And there were some rules that were changed after that one.
Oakland was responsible for quite a few rules.
First and 10, I remember that. I remember watching it in the highlights. I wasn't watching the game live. I remember watching the highlights when it happened the same Sunday. Look out. Looking to the outside here, trying to turn the corner. Doesn't quite do it. Not much there. Good defensive pursuit there laterally. And that was number 2. He just had no room to work with. He couldn't find a gap. Rivaldo, R-I-V-A-L-D-O. I like that name. Rivaldo Meza, wide receiver, senior. Both these sides will kind of mix things up. Sometimes wing backs will be running backs, and running backs will be slot receivers. They really kind of switch and change things, Santa Ana and Godinez both. They often have the same group of guys on the offense and for the multi-squad, but they're not always in the same positions on the field. They'll mix things up. Makes it interesting. They actually lost 2 yards on that. I thought he got at least a no gain, but they lost 2. Second and 12. Quarterback has a little time, puts it up, mid-range pass. Oh, a little too low, just a touch off target. Oh man, intended man. There were defenders nearby, but he had a chance at it. Damian Macias, incomplete.
Awful tough to roll to your left, and he tried to turn and get his shoulders turned going back to throw underneath, because good defensive position, had him to the outside. He couldn't lead him out to the sidelines. He had to throw behind, and that's an awful tough throw to make. Good throw, but not good enough.
I was looking at the Saints' schedule this year. Of their 10 games, of course, is the first game of the year.
half of them, or more than half of them, at least five are on Thursdays. I mean, you know, it's easier to do it on Saturday or Friday because you can sleep in a little bit on Saturday. All the schools, the coaches have practice on Saturdays. Their guys come in and do some swimming, do some stretching, and watch some film. But, you know, it's easier to have a little time to sleep in. But, you know, that's tough when you got a lot of Thursday night games like they do this year. Incomplete. That one was a little bit too high on the right side. Right idea, but put too much juice on it. Incomplete, and they'll be punting, the Saints will.
Good job by the Saints picking up the blitz that time. He had time to throw. Good pass, a little high. A lot of mustard on that one.
Saints, Ulysses Pompa is probably the kid for, the defensive line of the Gardena's Grizzlies, who's put the most pressure on the quarterback. We haven't seen a sack from him yet, but he's a returning starter, and he had a good season last year for sacks. He's the swiftest out there on the defensive side for Gardena's. They batted out of bounds, so no return. We haven't seen too many punt returns here today. So at least the Saints have pushed him back to a relatively deep field position to around 20. Plenty of time to work with, though. We have 9:16 here in the second quarter.
Very good snap, very good punt.
And we said some goofy, sloppy plays here tonight, some poor execution, some really good execution. We've seen plays that have gained a fair amount of yards that just immediately get called back because of the penalty. So clean it up and we'll have a more fun game here. Rule number one of football is don't beat yourself. And rule number two, hang on to the football. Don't, you know, maintain position. So 17 for the Grizzlies, who haven't really thrown the ball all that much tonight, but maybe once if that. They like the ground game, even though they run out of the shotgun. And the quarterback takes off. He's looking for some room here, right down the middle. Down he goes. Not much help there. The middle blocking didn't help out. It broke down. Down goes the ball carrier. The ball carrier was the quarterback number 23. Gets slammed pretty quickly. Patrick McMorris, sophomore, 5'9", 150. That's not a big kid out there. When you get hit hard, that can add up. He eats more meat on his bones, but he's a youngster. So no gain, or maybe a loss of about half a yard. Inside penetration's been doing pretty good here tonight for the Saints in red. They don't look too bad. And the Saints have been healthy outside the receiving brothers for the most part. Actually, they lost 2 yards. That was like a little over there. It's second and 12 from 15. Backs up. He wants to put it up. He puts it up. It's caught right in the middle there. A short screen, but then he smothered right away almost. Might have gotten, they got past the line of scrimmage. They gained a couple yards on that, about four maybe. Caught by number 13, but that was right in the middle of traffic. And number 13 is Isaac Verduzco. Verduzco, 5'8", 160. So, that's kind of hard to make a catch, not only in traffic, Knox, but not for many yards. And you know you want to get what you can, but he had big guys thundering all around. To doing that, and that kid was not big.
We have 7:47 left in the first half. Clock is running. Gardena's leading Santa Ana 6-0. Gardena's with the ball.
Got two field goals. He's a touchdown on the north end zone here last quarter with the missed extra point. And a bad snap. Take the shotgun snap here. And the cross runner takes it and he runs into the middle of the line for the Saints. Down he goes. About three red shirts involved in that stop. Good defensive penetration. Leading perpetrator on the play looked like for the Saints, number 15, Leo Busio. Busio, defensive end, junior, 6'2", 220. Lays the lumber. He's one of the bigger kids, no doubt about it, on that Saints squad. So a few plays and out. Nice to see that the Saints can stop him early. Good job by them. Field position should play a factor here. If they can get a... They need a good punt, but this is a good punter as we've seen already, so if they can rush him well or just have it be an average punt, they should be working with a relatively short field. Return man is actually in his own territory about roughly at the 47 at the Insignia. So he's right, actually the 45-yard line almost. Ah, wow. Or a penalty like that when you're...
Special teams, especially if somebody gets hurt. And then you got a substitute and it's hard to remember you're on our team. They got that first game of the year, that's a mistake. That's a mental mistake they shouldn't have made. That'll cost them five back in their own end.
It's even taller with the punting. Punter is punting from the shadow of his own goalposts. They need a good snap here. right to him. Very nicely done. A big rush, though. Look out. Gets it away. The guys are coming in for him. And takes a bounce and bounces near the returner. And he stays wisely away from it. That's good coaching. And he wanted to hit him, and he'll just down it on the 42-yard line.
Excellent kick. Excellent kick. Good roll. Get the ball bouncing. And if you're on the receiving end of that, don't hang around. Nothing happens. It's like nothing good happens after 2 a.m. Nothing good happens when the ball's bouncing around. You're not going to pick it up, and all I can do is bounce into you, and then you're the go to the game, and you'll never forget it. And they will remind you of that at your reunion 30 years later.
You're probably right about that. They made the right move. So Saints even with the good punt here. That was a punt of about, let's see here, 48 yards. No return, of course, with the bounce. So Saints still with a relatively short field, 58 yards in front. Plenty of time, 16-7 there, down by six. And they will come out split receivers, split wide. And a little confusion there on the offensive backfield. They're taking a little sweet time, and they got to hurry it up. No tight ends are in, four receivers are in, one setback, and that's it.
Got the CS back at quarterback now.
There's a change in here. He tosses it. He took off before he had the ball. A little bit of a low throw, but
yeah.
Intended receiver there was number 17. Number 17 is Pablo Aguirre. Aguirre kind of sort of took off a little bit before the ball was there. Didn't secure it. Incomplete.
He blinked. Good play, though, because that little hesitation.
Right idea.
That little hesitation brought the defensive man in. He was open. You got to catch that.
So Devant Gort given shouting. He's in the solid white red shirt there. With the receding hairline, don't mean to point that out, but just want you to recognize him on the sidelines there. And he is the head coach and runs his own offense. He's his own offensive coordinator. Of course, most head coaches are usually on-campus men. He is. And usually run one side of the team. Second and 10 after the incompletion. Three receivers are in. Two setbacks this time. He pitches it to the deep man, looking for some room on that left side. Cuts in. Flag is shown as he goes down.
They got a hold. He had his arm on his shoulder and his helmet, and when he finally went down, they threw it. I was watching that happen to be right in front of us. You probably saw the same thing. Although our cameras move, so it may not be right in front of you right now.
So that was number 17 once again. He's keeping busy here tonight, Pablo Aguirre. Again, wide receiver. Sometimes come out of the backfield, though. 5'10", 171 pounds. He's a junior. I think he split time between JVs and varsity last season. Back in 2015. Saints last season had a pretty successful season, at least during the regular season. They went to 8-2 and lost in the first round. The playoffs are marking out the penalty right now. And they kind of fizzled out in that first round quickly, unfortunately. And the criticism could be that the pre-league schedule wasn't all that tough, wasn't all that challenging. You want to have a pre-league schedule. Coaches are responsible for making their own pre-league schedules, games before league games. And you want to have schools that are about your level, maybe one or two that are above your level, maybe one or two that are below your level for, you know, hopefully getting a victory, but not always after pre-league games are done is the schools with the best records necessarily the best teams. It's all about your competition. Second and 22 after the penalties here. Hands it off to Aguirre. Look out.
Good play.
Nice run. Nice run. Nice move. Nice space on the right side there. Gets upended. Let's go flying. He's down there at the original line of scrimmage. They are about 8 yards short of the first down. But a nice run gets a lot of that yardage back.
Excellent play. They had a blitz on that side. Guy got a great running start. Ran the reverse right by him. He couldn't pivot fast enough. He said, oops, there he goes.
Yeah, some of those defensive players were too deep into the backfield before they realized what hit him. And he took full advantage of that. So his scamper gets his Saints out to the minus 44. Their own 44. And they're looking at third down and pretty long still. About 8 yards, we'll call it. Yep. So they'll send on the long side, the wider side of the field, three receivers, which is what they like. Usually, like, they'll usually come out with four receivers, and that long side will always have two, usually three. That part of it doesn't change all that much. Slot guy takes it. It's Aguirre once again. Makes a catch. Knows he's got to do something with it afterwards. Still on his feet. He's short the first down. And he finally gets turfed. Does some damage for about 5 yards, but that's about it. About three guys involved in that stop. Nice committee team tackling there. The lead guy to bring him down was the big guy, Ricardo Martinez, defensive tackle, junior, 5'10", 286 pounds. That is one big kid. I would not want to see the food bills in his family. He probably eats a lot of peanut butter.
This is an important play. We have 4:36 left in the first half. This is sort of a first crucial play. Right at midfield, as you can see, 49-yard line, full 2 yards to go, maybe three, and they're going for it. Play defense and put him back in the hole or try to go for it. Could be a big turning point. I think they got five free yards. Oh, the old hard count. I don't know if it was a hard count, but that's what it amounted to. It worked. He had five free ones. Once in a while, that does work, especially earlier in the year. You see the pros, the college do it all the time. I'm not sure that's what they were doing because he wasn't throwing his shoulders in the whole act you go into where you eat the scenery for a couple of minutes trying to get you to jump. But a good play, first and 10.
It did what it was designed to do. Pompa, P-O-M-P-A, the fastest kid at that defensive line, guilty of the infraction. We don't mean to notice him when he makes a mistake, but he'll rack up. I'll bet you that kid will probably have 10 or 12 sacks before this season is out. Maybe more. He's known for it. He's talented. Just made a mistake this time. First and 10 from the plus 46. Look out. The Saints with some room to run that right side. Nice cut. Look out. Still on his feet, the little guy. Blues his way down all the way to the 30-yard line. Nice job, a 16-yard scamper. How about that? Not bad. Wow. Number 20. And again, it's a variety of guys from the Saints as well. Alan Pacheco, running back, strong safety. Well, he gets his guys at first down on first down.
That was number 20, Alan Pacheco, listed at 5'5", 140. That's the listing. Junior, fine run. Good cuts two or three times downfield.
Nice job. 31-yard line, 15-yard gain. I thought it was 16, but still a good gain. Look out. Deep man takes it. Blizzard, nice cut right through the middle of the defensive line, and he gets about a good 4 or 5 yards. Kind of gains yards as he goes down. Coaches always like that. Maybe about 4 yards. Not bad.
To make a very long story very short, I knew a coach years ago who told me he trained his running backs when they were out 5'5". He said, run like you're 180 and you're 6'1". Run like you're big, and this kid is.
He did a nice job. Got him 4 yards. That was hard earned, but he made a count. Second and 6. Clock is ticking with just a little more than 3 minutes remaining here in the first half. The Saints have 2 timeouts remaining. Godinez, 1, fakes the give, rolls to that left side, the long side, look out. Can he set up? This is not easy to do when you're a righty. Runs to the left side, toss it just a little too high. Just a touch off target, the right idea, but no, just not quite there. Tui Levaya was the intended receiver, hits the ground.
Remarkably athletic pass on the target. In between people, on the move, throwing behind you, trying to turn back. He put it on his upper hand, in stride, really tough catch. I'm not saying, but it's one of those, that was a remarkably good pass in the circumstances.
Yeah, he was stretched across with his arms there. The pass was kind of near his shoulder, opposite side from where he was turned with the front of his body. It's that was a tall order. That was good. Just need a little bit more on target.
255 left in halftime. We need 6 yards for Santa Ana.
Third down, come out shotgun. I don't think we've seen one regular shot, one regular snap here tonight. Either side, look out, long side running. That's a giddy. They're fighting for what he can. Pablo, 5'10", 171, goes out of bounds. We'll stop the clock, but I think he assured the first down. And the linebacking crew gets him out of bounds.
Interesting, they really spread everybody out that time. Usually the rule is, if you're going to go outside, keep them inside. They spread them out and ran wide. That was unusual. They got him out in space, got a good cut, made a good gain. They're going to be short by maybe a foot.
I thought he got less than that, but yeah, fourth and
okay.
One on the board there.
Fourth, here we go.
Formation, and he's staying in shotgun. Three receivers to the right side. Quarterback steps up. Look out! He wants to go for it himself. I think he got enough. He didn't need that much. Down he goes. Damian Macias, nice job, Macias. He didn't take too long to make that decision. He got hit and knocked down there by a couple of guys, including big number 16, the tall one. For the Godinez Grizzlies, 16 is Luis Chavez, free side safety. Also, this is a strong side safety. They'll shift him around a little bit. He's a senior, 6 foot, 168. Returning starter, I believe, from last season's team, 2015. Makes a stop. Saints get the first down, though. Clock continues to tick as that ball got stopped in the middle of the field. So they still have a clock in their favor. They're down here near the end zone. Nice catch here. Gets his body behind it. Little bit of dipsy doodling here. Stays on his feet, and he goes all the way in. Nice moves. How about that? Pablo Aguirre, maybe not the fastest guy around, but man, that guy, he faked him out, and that's the reason why he scored that touchdown. Very nice moves, and you got to give that kid deserves a gold star on his helmet. Give him a sticker on his helmet for that one. That was a pretty play, and that was virtually all him after he scored the ball.
Yep, Pablo Aguirre, there's a rule on punt returns, and it works there too. You get the ball, it's up to you to get past the first guy. Then the blocking may help. Well, he got past the first guy beautifully and then juked a couple more. That was a run.
Two nice moves on that one.
At least two nice moves. Very good moves.
I like seeing that. Extra point attempt, number 18. Ricardo Garcia. Pardon me, Ishmael Mojica. Mojica boots it through. And it's good, and it's a 7-6 lead for the Saints.
Good snap, good hold. 19 took his time, got the ball in.
His kicker, I like his last name, Mojica. M-O-J-I-C-A. That almost sounds like a cup of coffee. I want to order a Mojica.
He is Ishmael Mojica. You can probably get that.
And the extra point is good, and the Saints lead is good, 7-6. By the skin of their teeth, but again, you never know. That could be a difference of a ball game. They say it's a game of inches. So the Saints, again, they're missing their two stars, the seniors. They were both two-year starters from last year, the year before, 14 and 15 seasons. The brothers Briseño, John is out with a shoulder sprain, and George Briseño had ACL surgery from last season, and he is just about healed, but he was not able to be cleared, unfortunately, for this first game. He was a little disappointed about that, obviously. Wanted to play, but he has to be medically cleared. They're a lot more careful these days about that. So they'll probably be back in action next week at the latest, 2 weeks from now. The brothers Briseño, the stars of the team. And I'm kind of a little bit disappointed because those guys, they are some exciting players. We saw the Seagrassum game last year, and Seagrassum kind of shut them down. But let me tell you, those guys get on the open field. I've announced football for about 30-some seasons, folks. I don't think I've seen more exciting players than them. They are really something to watch. They're fun.
The player I saw last year was that running back from Garden Grove.
Oh, yeah. He was something else.
He's sure good, but the Garden Grove guy was in a class by himself.
That's right.
Major league kick.
That was a nice one.
Into the end zone in high school. You don't see that very often.
You don't.
Mojica's a fine kicker. Got the extra point in there, too. That was a great leg. If first kick was good, that was better. You do that, you're a better coach.
Seeing some strong special teams here tonight for the San Dimas, for the Santa Ana Saints. And
but right now, it's the only difference is the extra point, special teams, and it was the snap. That'll do it.
And don't forget, folks, there's three squads on every team, offense, defense, and special teams. And special teams can make a big difference. You never know. Coaches do not take it for granted, and they are serious about coaching it. So first and 10 for Godinez in their dress whites. Really like that color scheme, black, yellow, and white. I often wonder why you don't see black or yellow, brown, and white. That's even a better combination, in my opinion, like the Wyoming Cowboys. Those colors really work well together. Scampers downfield, caught him from behind, but not before the damage is done. Gets the first down on first down. That was a quarterback taken off. Not bad. Got 11 yards or so, maybe 12. How about that? That was number 33 for the Grizzlies. 23, Patrick Morris. Forgive me, Patrick McMorris. McMorris. Like a Scotsman, sophomore. Yep, got actually 13 yards on that play. Very nice. Very nice play. And 2 minutes, 6 seconds and ticking here. Two receivers to the long side, the right side of the quarterback. Flag is thrown as the play develops here. Still spinning around, still on his feet. Look out, bring him down finally from the ankles there. A good hit by, number 28 had the ball. 28 ran all over the field for that one. Andy Sosa, running back, brought down by Damian Macias. One of the both-way players here for the Saints. But we have a flag here.
Procedure on the up.
Seen a few of those here tonight. So the Grizzlies, again, we've seen these procedures calls and these penalties and some of the nicer plays, the longer games tonight. It's always the nice plays that where they're guilty.
And a legal procedure, there's only one way to take care of that. Discipline, practice over and over, get the right stuff, stop moving. It's the little things. That's first game. That's first game stuff.
Yeah.
You don't see that nearly as much later in the season. We had several of those.
Theoretically, you should not see as many of those in the later games.
Yeah,
that's
you
correct.
Should not.
Yeah. Should not. Keyword is should.
Should.
If you got that up a problem, and even in midseason, you got a problem. So first and 15 changes the situation quite a bit at their own 28. So they retain the first down, but they stay in shotgun. Gap between the center and one of the guards there. Oh, man, they penetrated.
Nine came around the back, ran all the way around. Fine job by nine.
I think that was actually number eight, Stephen Cruz. Stephen Cruz on the stop there. Number eight. Big guy, too. Stephen Cruz. D-E and a T-E. He's both. But mostly as a defensive end, plays tight end sparingly. 6'3", 275. He's a senior. Actually, he's 285, according to Coach Steve Engort. He said he was about 260 last year and 6'2". Again, he's 6'3", and now 285. He is a load, and you got to probably have two guys on him, or definitely your biggest offensive lineman. And the biggest offensive lineman for the Godinez Grizzlies, to me, looks to be number 66, Jason Flores, Jr., 6'2", 291. But he still gives a lot of, they're about even. So he's got the assignment tonight, a guy about his same size. So basic physics lesson there. Look out, first wave misses, the second wave gets him down, he goes, no gain. Actually a loss of about three or four.
He's They're back. Using speed rushing now. They're just flying around there.
Yeah, middle of the line is to
yeah,
tonight.
Yeah, and they're
great job tonight.
But they're just roaring past him. Reminds me of that great game of UCLA-USC maybe 10 years ago when that fine tackle with played up the street here at Tustin. When UCLA just speed rushed him, whatever the right way to say that is, speed rushed him, and just blew, he was like standing still. And that's what they're doing here. They're just running right by him. They're not taking him on. They're going by him, getting to the backfield, meeting the quarterback before the play has a chance to get started.
The offensive line coach for the Michael Estevez is, of course, the head coach. He's his own offensive coordinator for Godinez, teacher on campus, English teacher. The offensive lines coach is Emilio Espinosa, also helping out with, on the offensive line is Gilbert Rodarte. They can't be too happy with the inside of the line. Again, you took two young pups in there. They're Mario's, Mario Aprecio on the left guard side, Lopez on the right. So they're getting a lesson, baptism by fire here tonight. But I'm sure they'll get a talking to in the locker room at halftime about better techniques. So 49 seconds remain. Plenty of yards to go for the Godinez Grizzlies. Third and 23. And they go down the middle here, or actually off to the left side. Dragging a few guys with him, but gets about 10 or 11, 12 yards. Maybe not bad, but of course well short of the first down. Sosa with the ball. He flies his way down to about the four, not quite the 40-yard line. He got hit and knocked down there by 45 for the Saints. Kevin Sia, the defensive lineman, stayed with him the whole way.
And we have a timeout on the field with 40 seconds left in the half. Santa Ana leading Godinez 7-6 with that one missed extra point. We have fourth and about six coming up. Santa Ana may get one more chance at the ball. But again, watch the center, as we have been all night long.
They call timeout. They want to preserve the clock. They want to get some
chance. Hey, get
not?
A chance.
Why not? I like seeing this. Not enough coaches do this, in my view, and it's nice to see that they're going to probably come out firing or use every second that they can for a score.
It's good football.
That is good football. Absolutely. One thing I do see tonight that is comforting to me, and I haven't seen it in the last few years, is an ambulance on site here. Of course, this day and age of cell phones, you can get an ambulance here pretty quick, but it's nice to see one on the premises. Although the last, I'd say, 7, 8, 10 years or so, that hasn't always been the case at high school games. Punts away, good height, good distance, and it gets punted out of bounds. It actually is punted into the stands. You don't see that very often here at the bowl. So way, way out of bounds, and they'll rule where it went out of bounds at around the 30-some yard line. He's going to say it went out of bounds at the...
He's still walking. He's still moving. He's up at the 40-yard line. Yeah, you're not returning this. It was a low kick, so there wasn't going to be much return when it, like that, but didn't get there. It went out of bounds. So it'll be first to 60 yards away. We have 33 seconds left. I don't know if they're going to try much. They may try to do a little bit, but they're not going to get too crazy. They're leading 7-6, and it is. Let's see if they can do a little bit of damage right here.
One timeout. If they throw it, I'm going to guess they're going to go mid-range or something. They do have one timeout, but now the quarterback is back in there, number 14, Julio Gomez. So they're playing switchy-changey, continuing with that. Three receivers to the left side, the long side. Snap is there. He's rolling to his left, looking for those three receivers. Down he goes midfield. Hits one guy in the hands, hit the second guy in the hands, but nobody got behind it and caught it. Swarming nearby was the defender, number 16. He broke it up a little bit there. Give some credit there to Luis Chavez. Maybe not a sticker on his helmet, but an attaboy and a pat on the rear end.
Julian Gomez, number 14, the quarterback now. They've been alternating a couple of them, and he's in there now. That good pass, it went through two people. They had too many people in the area with the pattern. Two incompletes and a bounce off a third person. All kinds of people had a chance for that.
Santa Ana fighting for those yards tonight, and I kind of like now they're marching off against the Saints here. I guess it's a 10-yarder, not 5 yards, 10 yards. Wow. Let's see here. I didn't see the call, but they march it back 10 yards to their own 31.
Holding.
So, yeah, more than likely was a hold. So it changes the situation. They might just kind of just sit on this ball and just call it a half, but they stay in shotgun because that's what they like. That's what both these sides have done all day here tonight. And kind of a mid-range to long pass, but too low. I'm guessing the intended receiver is Pablo Aguirre. That one was unfortunately near his feet. There was a little bit of pressure, not too much. That was just a bad pass, just too low.
Tough place to make a catch down the middle like that.
23 seconds to work with the Saints, and
Didn't get something here. You may see, you probably will see Godinez get the football back.
Well, if this isn't complete, Godinez might call timeout.
Yeah, right. Yeah, I didn't think about that. Yeah. My guess is the Saints are going to run the ball to run the clock out.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if they ran it right here.
I don't think, because a pass, you risk getting intercepted, and you run it, you get stopped, the clock continues to tick. And of course, though, like you said, Godinez, they have the timeout, so we'll see what they want to do. Shotgun, they stay from the 30. Oh, a little bit of movement on the line there. I think he had a guilty party of one of the linemen there jumping before the ball was snapped. Now, that is the case. And they will march back even farther to the 26. So it'll be third and 25 yards to go for the Saints, decked out in their full reds. Might not be able to tell, but they have a little bit of that light blue piping. It's kind of like the Houston Oilers' old colors, but, of course, dominant red instead of dominant light blue slash sky blue. But it's a good color combo. Third and 25 from their own 26. High snap, handles it, though. Keeping it on the ground here. Here they go. Running to the outside. Puts the stiff arm on the one guy. Puts the stiff arm on the second. Still Dispy Doodle running. Stays in bounds. Burns the clock. Or tried to do all he could to stay in bounds. I think he got chased out of bounds. But a good bit of footwork there by Damian Macias, at least to kill the clock. He knew he wasn't going to get any first down because they had to get to past the 50-yard line for it. But that was a gutsy play. He did all he could with what he had. And he fought off those defenders and just melted the clock as much as he could. 14 seconds remain. They roll the clock. No, let's see here. Does Godinez call timeout? Let's see. It'll be fourth down and 24. And let's see. Are they going to? Well, I'm sorry. The clock has stopped because it was out of bounds. That's right. My mistake. Okay, so that's why the clock has stopped. And Godinez. Okay, pardon me, it's third down? Let's see here. Yeah, it's third down. I'm looking at the scoreboard. The scoreboard says fourth down. The down marker says third down. Always trust the down marker. I didn't. He's still on his feet. His knee did not hit. Look out. Aguirre still with his ball. Look out. Takes off to that wide side. The right side still thundering. Another missed tackle. He's still on his feet. Look out. He cuts in. Can he get all the way? Spins around. Down he goes. And he's going to be out to about the 20-yard line. Oh, what an exciting run of about 50 yards, but he cut in instead of out to stop the clock. No.
The clock didn't start.
Oh.
It's now 7. It was okay. 14. It didn't start till it was halfway down. Yeah. Penalty flag on the play.
Yeah.
And by the way, one of the things they talked about is keeping people off. Now, there's a penalty here.
Yeah. Is it a penalty because they came on the field?
I don't know. Maybe. But I don't think that clock stopped. I don't think there's 7 seconds left.
I don't think so either.
That was
a longer run
because
than
he was
seconds.
Halfway down before they started that. But they're getting another play in. They're going to run the play.
I think you're going to get an argument.
I think their coach is going to talk about it in a minute.
That was bad clock.
Their coach wants to talk about it. I think that's what I saw.
That clock operator was the sleep of the switch.
Yeah.
Let's be honest.
I believe so.
That was longer than 14 seconds.
Yeah.
I can tell you that right now.
No, it didn't. I looked up and there was 14 seconds. He was after.
I didn't notice that.
Yeah,
you did, but
I happened to notice it. And that's what they're trying to explain. And I.
Yeah, he's not happy. Estevez is talking.
Because they get an extra play.
I would not back down on this.
No.
If I was him.
Well, there's only so much you can do, but you got to make your case.
That's, yeah.
And they're going to let him go. Okay.
Well,
I believe a mistake was made, but I can't. Yeah. I can't prove it.
If they score here, he's going to have a complaint with the CIF, I can assure you of that. He slams the football down to just stop the clock.
They stopped it on purpose now. Because they,
Start
the clock. So they get one play, they'll get the field goal probably. With Macias.
Yeah. Head coach Mike Estevez of Godinez, he's not happy right now, and I understand why. That was, the clock operator wasn't doing his job. I don't think that was anything done on purpose. He was just asleep at the switch, and this half should be over. And if they score here, he's not going to be happy. Times three. So they're going for the field goal here. They're in field goal range, you could say. Mahika for the 25. It'll be a 35-yarder. The hold is there. The snap is down. The kick is up. It looks good to me. Plenty of distance. Does it have the accuracy? It does. It does. And the Saints close out the first half with a field goal going through at the north goal. It's 10-6. So the Santa Ana Saints here tonight, without their two biggest stars, their brothers Bassenio, are in the lead. In a game that's had a lot of wacky plays and a lot of penalties, bringing down nice plays and clock up.
Maybe not. I'm not sure. I'd love to see a replay of that. We actually have it in the film here. We won't see the replay ourselves. But somebody had a look at that. I'm not sure that was done correctly. It might have been. I may have missed it, but I don't think so.
Yeah.
Let's go down here.
Yeah, your eye was on the clock more than mine was. But my point is that should not have happened. I mean, there's really no excuse for that. And if I'm Mike Estevez, I am not going to back down. I'm going to make my argument to the CIF office and say there was something wrong, because there was. And let me tell you something, that shouldn't have happened. But and it could be the difference in the ball game because you're now down by four instead of you're down by one. And, you know, that could be a difference maker in a tight game like this. You never know. But let Sleeping Dogs lie for right now. It's 10-6, the Saints, fair or not. But we've seen an interesting game that's had a lot of events defensively, offensively, penalties-wise. We've had everything but a block punt in this game, Knox.
Just about. The extra point hurt Godinez, and both teams have had people break into the open. Pretty good defenses. Offenses okay. Passing, pretty good. Especially for Santa Ana, it's been there. But they haven't made a lot of completions, but they're close. Doing a lot of things. First game jitters. A lot of legal procedure penalties. Good first game.
Finishing first half. We'd just like to see a little more cleaner football maybe in the second. If they can get the penalties down, it makes the game go quicker. And, just good quality football is always good to see. So that's the only thing I'm hoping for. But we've got the Saints here in the home opener on September the 1st, Thursday night here at the Bowl, 10-6. Home game for them. You can hear the Santa Ana High School Saint band in the background. My name is Peter Pigskin Hebrick here for good old SAUSD TV, Channel 31 on your Time Warner station here in the city of Santa Ana, along with Knox Wazzy. We'll take a halftime break. Stay tuned. We'll be back.